Heyo everyone, this is a Happy Anime Cafe Manager here with another Let's Play for Fire Emblem Three Houses.
The beast that appeared back then looked just like him. So Rhea is the Immaculate. The book said that it was the servant of the goddess. But wouldn't it make sense if beasts like that are actually children of the goddess?
I don't know.
Rhea is in a grim state right now. It's possible she may not make it. We have things we must ask her about. Once things calm down a little, let's go and see Rhea. Together. The truth can't be delayed anymore.
And Rhea did promise she was going to say something to be a billet. Like, come on, don't say you got something important and then die on me.
Part 2. Verdant Wind. Verdant Rain Moon. Fodlan's New Dawn. With the destruction of Shambhala, the ambitions of those who slither in the dark are forever shattered. However, Rhea has suffered grievous injuries in the process. Yet, certain mysteries remain unsolved, so Claude and the others approach Rhea, who is now confined to her room due to her wounds.
Sorry to interrupt your rest, but there are some things that we absolutely must ask you.
It seems I do not have much time left. I do not intend to hide anything any longer.
Rhea, I have to ask, you're the Immaculate, aren't you? If what I'm thinking is correct, that's what the Children of the Goddess is referring to. In other words, you.
I. Child of the progenitor god. A long time ago, the progenitor god came from somewhere far away and descended upon this continent. She changed her form to resemble that of a human and gave her own blood to birth her children. The progenitor god and her children shared knowledge and skills with the people of the land. Together, they built a prosperous civilization. But the humans turned their backs on the teachings of the progenitor god and engaged in senseless wars. Eventually, people began to think of themselves as gods and challenged the progenitor god herself to battle. The land was scorched in the war that ensued, and the majority of humans were annihilated. I believe those who slither in the dark are the descendants of those who retreated beneath the
So they've been waiting all that time for their chance at revenge.
It took the progenitor god an astonishing amount of time to revive the ravaged world. But eventually, the continent found peace again. And the progenitor god, having fulfilled her duty, fell into a long slumber in the holy tomb. The children who stayed behind built a settlement in Xanadu to protect the holy tomb as they quietly lived out their lives. But then, Nemesis appeared, bringing tragedy along with death. Even now, I cannot forget the sight of that massive canyon, painted red with blood. I was never able to forgive those who proudly wielded weapons crafted from the corpses of my brethren. I was the only survivor of Xanadu, and all I could do was wander across Odlin, clinging to my desperate desire for revenge. I called myself Zeros, fostered the founding of the Empire, and prepared to oppose Nemesis and his followers.
Unbelievable.
I put Xanadu behind me to gather the remaining children who were scattered across Woodland. Finally, we killed Nemesis on the Tailteen Plains, and I took back the Sword of the Creator.
Well, let me get this straight. Saint Cyros is you? You're kidding me, right? Professor, Claude, there's something you need to hear right away.
If you have something to report, do so at once. There is no need to let my presence worry you.
As you wish. We're receiving a constant stream of express messages from cities to the east. They claim that an unidentified military force is attacking, and that there have already been a large number of casualties. What? The reports indicate that the cities and towns along the east Grande thoroughfare in the old Rim territory have already been destroyed. Some villages were razed completely, leaving no survivors. Damn it! Did they come from Shambhala? Some remnants of that wicked group hiding there.
I have a report. The unidentified military force has crossed the Great Bridge of Mergen. Alliance forces met them in battle, but it seems they have already broken through.
They've already made it so far. Is Count Gloucester unarmed?
The Count is fine, but apparently my brother joined the reinforcements and was greatly injured.
Do you mean to tell me they easily got past a general as skilled as Holst?
They say the enemy general has a weapon that resembles the Sword of the Creator. Even my brother was powerless to stop him.
The Sword of the Creator?
That's not possible.
The enemy forces are flying a banner bearing the crest of wings as they continue their march west along the Aramid River.
We believe they're marching toward Garrett. We are preparing to meet them in battle.
Weapon that resembles the Sword of the Creator. And banner bearing the crest of flames. There is only one explanation. The one leading the enemy to Mars is Nemesis himself.
Nemesis? That Nemesis? Do you really think the ancient king of liberation has been brought back to life?
Perhaps the seal is broken, but Shambhala fell. An incredible power that we children cannot hope to match. Dwells within the blood of the progenitor god. Nemesis obtained that blood, so it will not surprise me in that case.
The blood of the progenitor god? That's right. He did take the remains from the holy tomb, didn't he?
From the blood of the progenitor god, Surface, he acquired the crest of flames. From her bones and heart, he crafted the sword of the creator.
The sword of the creator is made from her bones and heart?
The heart of Silas is the crest stone that was placed in the Sword of the Creator. The same is true of the crests of the Tenements and the other crest stones. They were born of the blood and hearts of the progenitor god's children. Those who slither in the dark created them, stole them. So this never gifted that power to the humans.
The crests of the Ten Elites, the crest stones, and the hero's relics. I can't believe those who slither in the dark made them all. And after that, Nemesis used the Sword of the Creator to massacre all of the progenitor god's children in Xanadu. In other words, the citizens of Xanadu were killed by weapons made from the remains of their brethren. How atrocious. But I don't get it. The Sword of the Creator that Teach wields doesn't have a crest stone. So how is Teach able to wield its full power?
The crest stone of the progenitor god dwells within your professor. After I battled with Nemesis as Saint Cyrus, I reclaimed the heart of Cyrus. I wanted to use that heart to resurrect her, even though I had to do some questionable things to achieve that goal. I wished to see Sophis, my mother, once more.
You place her heart in me? Ugh.
Yes. I believed that if I could resurrect my mother, I could regain all that had been lost.
So, that's the truth of it.
I suspected that your body housed the consciousness of Cyrus. Your suspicions were correct. And yet, she merely gave you her power and vanished. Wish did not come true. When you did inherit the
So Beelitz is like the Fire Emblem version of Naruto. Yeah, that was a long cutscene. I mean, in the time they've chattered, I could be in breakfast. The 70% chance for sniper. Oh, come on, really? Yeah, I might as well get my waffles while I wait for the game to load. Yeah, the next part is gonna be even longer. The thing with old syrup bottles. Okay, so usually I have it sit upside down. And Jemima bottles are not the perfect specimen for that. They should really take notes from those ketchup companies. And which the top part of it must always go dead down where. Okay, so you know what I'm saying here. As far as ketchup balls go, like, you know how they make ketchup balls that have a wide top, more like a bottom that the ball looks like it could go upside down. That way, it makes it easier for the remaining ketchup to slide that down. Instead of having to go through the trouble of hitting it on one end for the ketchup to go down as you're trying to squeeze out whatever's left, because nobody wants to go through the hassle of getting another going to the grocery store just to get another bottle. Well, it's a step in the right direction for human evolution. For fucking real? That was a high percent chance right there. Man, why is all the other units suck today? Oh, good to know. You cannot repair weapons mid-battle. There's 4 weeks of teaching. Let's get to exploring now. Supply run. Alright, when I find Hilda. Okay, so when I find Hilda, I'll give her the supplies. Well, thanks for watching, everyone. Until next time, to be continued, baby.